in the ring to my right, from Downers Grove, Illinois.
Hot dog, that means I get to hear another poem. The poet laureate of the World Wrestling Federation.
Only guy I know who writes poetry on frisbees.
Has a poem for us all.
Generally, it goes in a book, don't it?
Don't it?
Terry Taylor's coming with the weasel at his side, and together they are reaching for the top. Bobby Heenan's gonna show the world why he's called the Brain if he can make a star of that conceited flop.
Terry Taylor
being led towards the ring by his manager, Bobby the Brain Heenan, from Vero Beach, Florida, weighing 240 pounds, Terry Taylor.
You're dead wrong.
What?
And you're in a lot of trouble. But from this point on, Mr. Announcer, let's get something straight. He is no longer to be introduced as Terry Taylor. I've selected a new name for him. He will now be known as the Red Rooster. You got me straight?
The Red Rooster?
Huh. He looks kind of like a rooster the way he moves around and struts his good, so to speak. Uh-oh. Look out. Rooster going to work here on Leaping Lanny Poffo. I guess he didn't like the poem, huh?
Huh, who could blame him?
Look at that maneuver.
Woo, that is vicious.
You can, you know, what's amazing, you can already see Heenan rubbing off on this guy.
Really?
Yes, definitely. I certainly can. And again, with those trifocals you got, McMahon, I suppose you can't.
A little consultation here. And you wonder exactly what Mr. Heenan is saying. So let's see if we can listen in.
Stay on him. Stay on him.
Bobby Heenan confident he can make a superstar out of Terry Taylor. Well, the Red Rooster. We spoke with Mr. Heenan earlier.
Take a good look, humanoids. That's my little Red Rooster in the ring. I'm taking this man with limited wrestling ability, limited size, and limited intelligence, and I'm going to groom him into one fighting machine. Another test for the Brain, and another test I'll pass.
You know, McMahon, being the concerned adult that I am, the former champion wrestler that I was, I think I should take it upon myself right now, McMahon, to tell all the children and the kids out there, and even the adults for that matter, please don't try any of these wrestling holds at home, because you can get hurt and hurt bad.
Indeed, leave it for the pros.
Leave it for me to do to McMahon.
Well, that should be interesting. What's he saying?
He's going to get a beef with Headline.
I'm on that ref. Turn around, huh?
Turn around and see what?
Acting like he was doing absolutely nothing. Well, look, he caught one there in the clip basket.
What would you suggest he do, Edmund?
I would suggest him.
I mean, should he tell the ref I was choking him, ref?
I'm not suggesting that, Jesse. Maybe he should not do that to begin with. Oh, come on. They're right in front of the ref's eyes.
That's the Heenan influence, I'm telling you.
Well, it's not a good influence.
It isn't?
I don't think so.
The Red Rooster's going to make more money than he's ever seen now that he's associated himself with the Brain.
And Rooster, with a devastating submission hold here. And it's all over.
How about that, Brain?
Here is the winner, the Red Rooster.
And you notice he waited for Bobby to snap his fingers before he broke the hold.
Yep.
This guy's listening. He's going to learn.
Now you wonder what the Red Rooster calls that hold.
I'll find out, McMahon. The next time we see him wrestle, I'll find out what he calls it.
Bobby the Brain along with the Red Rooster. The Rooster chalks up a victory just like Heenan said he was going to do.
There you see Bobby doing his job, distracting the referee while the Rooster gets in a little choke. Beautiful double arm suplex right there on Leaping Lanny. I wonder if he's got any poetry in mind right now. And there's the Rooster with his submission hold, which I promise you I will get the name what he calls that, McMahon.
Standing by right now is Brother Love.